Hello everyone, welcome to Opipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. Today we are going to do discussion on Production Linked Incentive Scheme, the PLI scheme, which has been recently in news and it has added 10 more sectors under it. We are going to discuss what these sectors are, what are the previous sectors that already were in the scheme. This topic is part of your GS3 syllabus that talks about economy and economic development in the country. So let's discuss in detail how this scheme is going to benefit us, right? Why is it necessary to launch such kind of scheme? What is the outlay for the scheme? Let's discuss. So recently, the Union Cabinet has approved 1.45 trillion production linked incentive scheme for 10 more sectors. The main targets of this scheme is number one, to attract investment. We want to make sure that there is more investment in the country. Second is to boost domestic manufacturing. Manufacturing ko badhawa dena chahte hain. Third is enable companies to become part of global supply chain. We want to make sure that Indian products are in the global supply chain. We are in the global economy. Fourth is to generate employment opportunities. So these are the focus areas why this scheme was launched. Right? To boost the domestic manufacturing, we want to make sure that we cut down our imports, we increase our exports, we are promoting investment in the sectors which are capital intensive, right? By providing cash incentives on the incremental sale from products manufactured in the country. Jo bhi products manufacture kiye jayenge, unki incremental sales ke upar incentives provide kiye jayenge. So that is about the scheme. And also, we are inviting foreign companies to set up shop in India. The scheme aims to encourage local companies to set up or expand existing manufacturing units. The aim of this scheme is to encourage domestic manufacturing, reduce imports and generate employment. Features of the scheme are that under the scheme, the companies will get incentives on incremental sale from products manufactured in the domestic units. Implementation of the scheme will be done by concerned ministries and departments. So these are the 10 sectors which are newly included in this scheme. And these are the implementing agencies, implementing ministries. Jaise ki aapki advanced chemistry cell battery hai, to is sector ke liye the implementing ministry is Niti Aayog and Department of Heavy Industries. Second is your electronic and technological products. Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Automobiles and Auto Components, Department of Heavy Industry, Pharmaceutical Drugs, Department of Pharmaceuticals, Telecom and Network Products, Department of Telecom, Textile Products, MMF Segment and Technical Textiles, Ministry of Textiles, Food Products, Ministry of Food Processing Units, High Efficiency Solar PV Modules, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, White Goods, ACs and LEDs, Department of Promotion of Industry and Internet Trade. 10th is your Specialty Steel, Ministry of Steel. We will discuss all these sectors, right, and why these sectors are important for under the scheme. Let's discuss. The above scheme will be in addition to the already notified PLI schemes in the following sectors. Three sectors were already there, right? Usme humne 10 aur add kar diye hain recently. So which are these three sectors which were introduced in March? Mobile manufacturing and specified electronics components which were under Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Critical drug intermediaries, active pharmaceutical ingredients and manufacturing of medical devices under Department of Pharmaceuticals. So what is PLI scheme? Well, it is basically to reduce our dependence on other countries like China. The government in March announced the scheme so as to give incentives to the incremental production by the domestic units, right? The scheme is applied to mobile and allied equipments as well as pharmaceutical ingredients and medical devices manufacturing. ये जो sectors हैं ये labor intensive sectors हैं, right? और it is expected कि यहाँ पे promote की जाएगी ज़्यादा employment opportunities so that more incentivization is given to this तो प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज होगा एंड प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज करने के लिए देर विल बी रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ मोर एम्प्लॉयमेंट राइट. ऑल्सो दीज सेक्टर्स आर लेबर इंटेंसिव सो दीज आर अंडर फोकस. ऑल्सो 1.45 लाख करोड़ का आउटले दिया गया है स्कीम को विच इज ऑपरेशनल फॉर 5 years. Right, it is implemented by the concerned departments that we have already discussed. Also, saving from one PLI scheme of an approved sector can be utilized to fund another sector. एक सेक्टर से जो भी आउटले रहेगा उस स्कीम का अगर वो कंप्लीट हो गया उसका टारगेट इट विल बी शिफ्टेड टू अनदर सेक्टर द फंड विल बी शिफ्टेड टू अनदर सेक्टर. सो वॉट इज हाउ डज दिस इंसेंटिव वर्क. सो वन इज इट एक्ट्स एज अ काइंड ऑफ सब्सिडी टू द सेक्टर राइट. ऑन प्रोडक्शन you are giving incentive, you are given funds on more production. It is a direct payment from the budget to goods made in India. Amount varies from sector to sector. Kuch particular amount nahi hai jo sub-sector ko diya jaye. It is varying on sector to sector. And it is based on disadvantage, disability faced by the sector. Product link incentive scheme. It is an outcome and output oriented scheme. राइट जो भी प्रोडक्शन होएगा उसके बाद उनको इंसेंटिवाइज किया जाएगा. इट विल बी पेड ओनली इफ द मैन्युफैक्चरर्स मेक द गुड्स राइट. इट ऑफर्स अ प्रोडक्शन लिंक्ड इंसेंटिव टू बूस्ट डोमेस्टिक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग अट्रैक्ट लार्ज इन्वेस्टमेंट इन मोबाइल फोन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग स्पेसिफाइड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉम्पोनेंट्स इंक्लूडिंग असेंबली टेस्टिंग मार्किंग पैकेजिंग 80 MP यूनिट्स विच आर अंडर मोबाइल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग राइट. सो PLI स्कीम विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द कंसर्न मिनिस्ट्रीज. Also, the cash incentives are given to 5 to 7 years and all sunrise and important sectors are proposed to be covered under this. So, the sectors may be mobile, networking, products, food, processing, advanced chemistry and solar PV manufacturing. The incentive can be extended from 4% to 6% on incremental sales over base year of goods manufactured in India and covered into target segments to eligible companies for over a period of 5 years. To the base year. The scheme envisages to boost local handset production that will meet the targets of National Policy on Electronics of 2019. So it is focusing on the mobile sector, it is focusing on the pharmaceutical sector. The basis of this is to focus towards the labor intensive sector, right? We want to create more employment opportunities, we want to create more manufacturing units. Right, you want to create India into a networking component manufacturer. This will be implemented through a nodal agency that acts as a project management agency. The scheme will also help the country to move towards the objective of Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliant India. So why the scheme is necessary? Well, it is also discussed ki ye scheme abhi is time pe launch karni sahi rahegi kya? Because we are facing in this COVID times, we are facing lack of investment there. Right? Lack of investment is there because the reason that we are having lack of demand. Demand is very low at this time, so it is discussed that is this going to be an over ambitious scheme. Well, whatever the concern may be, but it is to ensure that there is increased production over a long term, which is 4-5 to 7 years. So it is kabhi to launch a scheme karni chahiye thi, which is very beneficial if it works accordingly. It is difficult for the government to make sustained investment in the capital intensive sector as they have longer gestation period. Also, government wanted to increase investment in the sectors which are capital intensive, right? Which are having longer gestation period. Unko startup hone mein bahut time lagta hai. Aise sectors mein we want to make sure that there is more investment. Also, jo PLI scheme hai, ye output pe based hai, right? Increment is given on output focus. Whereas there is scheme like Mega Food Parks, which is also for the food producing processing units. But it is input oriented. It is based on the grants that are given by the government. So those who are capable of mobilizing the initial investment to brownfield on or greenfield projects by themselves, it is going to be a great factor for those investors who are going to mobilize the initial investment for the brownfield and greenfield projects by themselves. So PLI scheme is to incentivize and invite global and capital rich companies to set up capacities in India. We want to promote manufacturing from India. It is not based that which kind of domestic manufacturing is taking place, no matter if it's a foreign company. We want to make sure the domestic manufacturing takes place, right? India mein manufacturing ko badhana chahte hain, no matters ki ye company kaun si hai. बेनिफिट्स जो हैं स्कीम के अक्रॉस दी 10 स्पेसिफिक सेक्टर्स आर कंसीडर्ड टू मेक इंक्रीज इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन द एरियाज ऑफ कोर कॉम्पिटेंसी कटिंग एज टेक्नोलॉजी इंश्योर एफिशिएंसी क्रिएट इकोनॉमीज ऑफ स्केल एनहेंस एक्सपोर्ट्स एंड मेक इंडिया पार्ट ऑफ इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ ग्लोबल सप्लाई चेन ऑल्सो इट इज़ टू पुश डिजिटल इकोनॉमी वेल इंडिया इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैव $1 trillion डिजिटल इकोनॉमी बाय द ईयर 2025 तो इंडिया का ये टारगेट है डिजिटल इकोनॉमी का इट इज़ एक्सपेक्टेड टू रीच दिस टारगेट राइट एंड फॉर दिस वी नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट इंडिया इज क्रिएटिंग दैट काइंड ऑफ मोबाइल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स एडिशनली द गवर्नमेंट पुश फॉर डाटा लोकलाइजेशन इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स प्रोजेक्ट्स सच एज स्मार्ट सिटी एंड डिजिटल इंडिया आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू इंक्रीज द डिमांड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स प्रोडक्ट्स increase exports. The Indian pharmaceutical industry is the third largest in the world by the volume and 14th largest in terms of value, right? Third largest in pharmaceutical industry mein and 14th largest in terms of value. It contributes around 3.5% of the total drugs and medicines exported globally. India is world's second largest steel producer in the world. It is the net exporter of finished steel. A PLI scheme is for in the specialty steel will help in enhancing manufacturing capabilities for value-added steel leading to increase in total exports. Well, what is specialty steel? It is made by adding various elements to the iron. जिससे कि उसकी प्रॉपर्टीज और एनरिच हो जाती हैं जैसे कि हीट रेजिस्टेंस हार्डनेस कोरोजन रेजिस्टेंस एट्सेट्रा सो एड केमिकल्स आर इट इज एन अलॉय काइंड ऑफ थिंग विच हैज एडिशनल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ आयरन सिक्योर टेलीकॉम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर राइट यू वॉन्ट टू मेक श्योर दैट वी हैव टेलीकॉम इक्विपमेंट्स दैट फॉर्म अ क्रिटिकल एंड स्ट्रैटेजिकल एलिमेंट ऑफ बिल्डिंग अ सिक्योर टेलीकॉम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड इंडिया एस्पायर्स टू बिकम अ मैन्युफैक्चरर original equipment manufacturer of telecom and networking projects doubling farmers income so jo humne food processing industry pe focus kiya hai it is to focus that there is better price given to the farmers and reduces the levels of wastage which sectors already have PLI scheme well it was introduced by the government in the March It made 53 bulk drugs eligible for PLI worth 6940 crore. The scheme is expected to benefit up to 136 manufacturing units, generating increment sales of 46,400 crore and significant additional employment generation over the next 8 years. It also announced 14,000 crore package that would incentivize production of active pharmaceutical ingredients and medical devices in the country. So, जो medical devices की production है country में उसको भी बढ़ावा दिया जा रहा है, right? For promoting manufacturing of medical devices in the country. Apart from pharmaceutical and medicines, the government also notified a PLI scheme for electronics and mobile phone sectors. In accordance with national policy on electronics and as a part of scheme, incentives of 4-6% will be given to electronics companies that manufacture mobile phones and other electronic components such as transistor, diodes, thyristors, resistor, capacitors, nano-electronic components such as micro-electrochemical systems in India. So national, मतलब आप focus कर सकते हैं कि इस scheme के through जो भी sectors include किए गए हैं उसके तहत अदर पॉलिसीज़ को भी फोकस किया जा रहा है जैसे कि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सेक्टर है तो इट इज़ फोकसिंग टुवर्ड्स नेशनल पॉलिसी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स ऑफ 2019 इफ देयर इज़ फार्माक्यूटिकल सेक्टर फार्मा सेक्टर इज देयर राइट सो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ मेडिकल डिवाइसेस को फोकस में लिया जा रहा है मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ मेडिकल डिवाइसेस को फोकस में लिया जा रहा है एंड इट इज़ टू मेक श्योर दैट देर इज इंक्रीज डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्शन इन दिस सेक्टर. ऑल्सो दीज आर कैपिटल इंटेंसिव एंड लेबर इंटेंसिव सेक्टर्स, राइट? दिस इज इन द फोकस. एंड अदर देन दैट फूड प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट्स आर देयर, जो कि ये फोकस करेंगे कि इंडिया में जो फार्मर्स की इनकम है वो डबल कर दी जाए और जो वेस्टेज है वो कम हो. सो दैट इज़ इन द फोकस, राइट? सो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस फार्माक्यूटिकल्स लेटेस्ट सेक्टर. वाइट गुड्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट एयर कंडीशनर LED कम्स अंडर वाइट गुड्स एंड दे हैव हाई पोटेंशियल ऑफ डोमेस्टिक वैल्यू एडिशन, राइट? दैट्स वाई वी वॉन्ट टू गिव मोर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग बूस्ट टू दीज सेक्टर्स एंड मेकिंग दीज प्रोडक्ट्स ग्लोबली कॉम्पिटेटिव. इंडिया इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैव $1 trillion डिजिटल इकोनॉमी बाय 2025. सो बाय दैट टाइम वी वॉन्ट टू मेक श्योर दैट इंडिया इज अ मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ टेलीकॉम एंड नेटवर्क प्रोजेक्ट्स, नेटवर्क प्रोडक्ट्स. इंडिया इज द वर्ल्ड सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट स्टील प्रोड्यूसर इन द वर्ल्ड. सो वी हैव फोकस ऑन द स्टील सेक्टर. इट वी हैव ऑल्सो फोकस ऑन द टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री, विच इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट इंडस्ट्री इन द वर्ल्ड एंड हैज अ शेयर ऑफ 5% ऑफ द ग्लोबल एक्सपोर्ट्स इन टेक्सटाइल एंड अपैरल्स. But India's share in the man-made fiber segment is low in contrast to the global consumption pattern. So all these scenarios is there, and even during this COVID times where we are suffering from lack of investment and lack of demand that is there, especially in the service sector, we are having very low demand. So we want to make sure that this scheme somehow turns beneficial in the coming time, right? Because we had to launch the scheme somehow and at one point of time. So the government is taking critical economic and financial measures to bring the economy back on its growth track. One of such measures is to introducing and extending production link incentive scheme in these sectors. The recently approved package will boost manufacturing, exports, forex earnings and employment. So it is a very beneficial scheme. I hope this helped you to understand this scheme in depth. For more such videos, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.